higher selves. We will talk about the sixth incarnation, that is Parashurama. Parashurama is actually a Brahmin who is supposed to be spending more time in meditation, and who is supposed to be in touch with the divine energies and such things. So he would have a lot of out of his tapas, basically he would have a lot of spiritual weapons. At his time, what happened was, the problem that came to the world was of the kings. Kings are supposed to be seeing their people as their own children, to have the dharma in place. But the problem of kings so happened that they started misusing the authority they had. So they started actually showing their physical powers on people, and things, all bad activities they started doing in the world. So it so happens that the king who belonged to the region of Parashurama, he would attack Parashurama's family. You can probably search the story of Parashurama in the Google. I don't touch the story because I'm going to touch the only knowledge. So Parashurama would hit him back. He would totally empty him off. With all his spiritual powers, he would wage the war against the king and he would defeat him. And the story doesn't end there. His children again come and then wage the war against the family of Parashurama. This time he again goes back, and then he sees the end of all those king's children. And then he takes the oath that the kings actually went away from the dharma in the world, and he would start killing all the kings in the world. He would start killing all the kings in the, especially the Asian continent. So he went on a spree of killing all the kings. Kings literally got scared, and then he would even, they would even hide themselves in the disguise of women and all. And they used to be in the disguise, kings used to hide in the disguise of Brahmins, etc. So what happened? He totally erased the authority of kings. He captured the entire Indian continent. And then he gives it off to Manu, one of the Manus, who knows the dharma and who could actually take care of the land properly. Land and the people properly. So he would donate this entire captured land to that man. So that's the story. So he would actually put back the dharma in place, that the kings or the people who have the authority, people who have, who is into management, who is like a CEO, or probably who is into management, and who have the people working under them, they are supposed to be seeing them as their own contents. They should not see them in a separated way, and then treat them in a separated way, and then cause them any problems. Whenever that problem comes of misusing the authority, I would manifest, is the campaign of the God or the supernatural power. Whenever the dharma goes out of the place, that is, when the people who have authority misuse their authority, then I would manifest, is the message that he communicates in this incarnation. No matter, especially the kings, wouldn't listen to, because kings, especially kings, they have they are into waging wars and all. They cannot listen to ordinary people are probably saints and all. They can only be taught in the manner of fighting, not oral fighting, physical fighting. That's why he took the physical warrior incarnation, wrathful warrior Parashurama. He would take that incarnation and then show the world that if the dharma goes out of the place in terms of misusing the authority, I would manifest. This is the message of the supernatural power of the sixth incarnation. Parashurama remains as Chiranjeevi, means he did not go to the source, but he remains in the source, but he hangs himself in the availability of the purpose of nature. He dedicated his soul forever for the welfare of nature, to balance the dharma, especially in terms of authority. People who are in authoritative states, they should not misuse their authority. For that purpose, he made sure that he is available always for the earth. And whenever there is a problem of this, he would descend down immediately. So, for that purpose, he remained himself as Chiranjeevi. And for the future purpose, there are several other secrets which cannot be revealed. For the purpose of the welfare of the world, to be available all the time, he made himself became Chiranjeevi. Hanuman was also like that. And there are several others. So, that is Parashurama. Now, let's talk about the seventh incarnation of the supernatural power, that is Rama. At the time of Rama, what happened was the middle part of India and the southern part of India totally was captured by negative energies. And the leader of all those negative energies was Ravana. He being in Sri Lanka, he would have so many relatives of his, cousins and all, uncles, aunts and all, spread across most part of India, leaving the up north part. What these negative energies would do is, they wouldn't let any spiritual people to carry their spiritual practices, especially many more saints, spiritual practitioners and all used to get lost in the used to get into deep meditation and all these. They used to conduct havans, they used to set up ashrams and all, and they used to teach dharma and spiritual practices to many more people. And they used to teach a lot of sciences then, mathematics and many other sciences were there in the Vedic form. They used to teach them. So these negative energies wouldn't let them at all to carry their practices. See, the saints and the spiritual practitioners are required to do their practices in the world. Especially if you go to Himalayas, and if you go to Nepal and all, Tibet and all these region, you find many people spending their time in meditation. Why? Meaning, some people are required to be spending more time in meditation and also to live a saintly life. That actually balances the world or the nature in a big way. Probably many more people are doing bad things today, but all those can be balanced in nature just by their deeds. I mean the actions of the saints or the people who are into meditation, who are dedicated to meditation and spiritual life and all. So some people are always there, dedicated to spend their lives in spiritual field, and that is required in the world, and that has to go on forever. Because their work actually balances the nature. So, in the same way, these people, spiritual people, when they were there in the forest at the time of Rama, this negative guy and his all folks and all used to wage war on these people. They used to literally kill them. So this guy, Ramana, he gets born as a king now. In the previous incarnation, he was born as a Brahmin boy who killed all the kings, and to balance that thing, he would take the birth in a king's family now. And then he leaves the kingdom to balance this dharma, to bring this dharma into the world. So what he does is, he gets into the forest, he keeps on killing all the folks of this guy. And he travels from up north to the deep south part of Indian continent, to Sri Lanka. So in that journey, he keeps on killing many more negative energies. All his cousins, aunts and all he would kill, and finally he would kill this guy. So for him, the campaign was only dharma. Dharma means spirituality, yajnas and sanatan dharma has to go on. If somebody plays with it, if somebody doesn't allow it, I will take the form of human. I will come into the world, and then I can do anything to bring that balance in the world, is the message that he passes. And for Rama, there were no relations that he was attached to. No wife, no children, no parents, no family, nothing. For him, only doing this universal work, only that was important and essential for him. And for that, he could leave anything. That kind of personality he was. So for him, only dharma was important. Love was secondary for him. Dharma was important for Rama. Love, importance to relations and all these were secondary. Rama is actually Shantrudra. Means he appears to be peaceful outside, but inside he is Rudra. Especially in terms of Rudra means he is dedicated himself to make sure that the dharma is always followed. So for that purpose, he would wage the war anytime. So following laws of nature is very, very essential for Rama. Rama is actually the extension of Parashurama, his previous incarnation. But this time he appears more peaceful, not wrathful like that. But you can say Rama is like smoother version of Parashurama. Smoother version of Parashurama. He appears to be smoother outside, but inside he is Rudra. So he makes sure that the laws of nature are followed. So that is what he proved throughout his life. For him, laws of nature, dharma, is very, 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 very important. And for that purpose, he sacrificed several things in his life to show the world. When the problem came, though it's not a problem, he had to send out his wife. He had to leave his parents. He had to leave his brothers. And several other things that he had to sacrifice in terms of relations. So he had to sacrifice love by giving more importance to dharma. So he asserted more on dharma, Rama. Dharma means God. God himself is dharma. Rama lived in a way like to show the world that dharma is very, very essential to live the life in the world. He lived in a way that dharma itself is Rama and Rama himself is dharma. There is no separation. Rama is equal to dharma. Dharma is equal to Rama. Rama himself is dharma. That is what he showed to the world.